So a lot of people had asked me how to play a song called Je te laisserai des mots. So I'm going to give you guys a quick tutorial how to do it. If you're not a good piano player, don't worry. I got your back. I'm going to make you play like you've been playing all your life. Well, there's tricks and there's ways of learning and I can teach you. So it's going to roll like this. First of all, we're going to do right hand, left hand separately so everybody can just take in the information. I want you guys always to, when you're learning an instrument, especially piano because it's so visual, like I said, there's going to be patterns that repeat throughout the whole song. You're trying to look for things in common so you're learning the least amount of information possible and getting the most out of it. So let's start with the right hand. The shapes, there's only, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There's only 5 shapes you need to know for the verse. 5 things, it's pretty simple. There's only 6 shapes you need to know. So there's the first one. Je te laisserai des mots en dessous de ta porte. Second shape. En dessous de les murs. Okay. Qui chante. Second shape. Notice that I'm not moving my fingers like this. I'm not like, I'm just starting here. I'm not going anywhere. I'm just moving my fingers really, least amount of movement possible. Super crucial. Back to the first shape we've already learned. So we already have something in common. And the only other difference after that, it just repeats that. And then it goes. Quand tu voudras, ramasse-moi. Quand tu voudras. So, why don't you just do me a little favor for the first week? Just practice slowly, and you're gonna see by the next week you're gonna be like, I'm amazing. So you've learned that shape. Now we're gonna go to the left hand. Left hand's even easier. So you have the bottom note. And basically you're just going 1, 2, 3, 2, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 2, 2, 3, right? Pretty easy. Then you're just going boom. Thing a little tricky is boom, 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 boom. I know it's going to be tough for you, these parts of your fingers, the 3, 4, 5, and or 1, 2, 3, depending on your hand, but these two fingers are the hardest fingers to learn to play piano. Just let the weight of your arm do the work for you. Just let the weight, and look, it's almost like I'm holding if you look like this sideways, it looks like I'm holding a tennis ball. And I'm just letting the weight fall all onto the finger that's pressing down the note. I never push the note because it sounds ugly. You just let the weight do the work and you direct all the weight of your hand and you make that one finger hold it up. So try it. Try to hold the weight of your hand like that. If you do this really slowly, these fingers, and it will take about 1 week and they'll be good. Got it? Because those are the only notes you need. So if I put them together really slowly for you. Je te laisserai tes mots en dessous de ta porte, en dessous de les murs. Oh my God, I ruined my own song. I'm not even. En dessous de les murs, qui chante tout près de la place où tes pieds se passent cachés dans les trous. Second part sounds like it's really hard, but once again, this hand does two things the whole time. You're gonna learn two shapes. First shape being. Sorry, make sure I got the thing I was keeping. Yeah, that's right. So I know it's going to feel weird, but use your finger number 2 on this note, and now up here, okay? That's one team. Make that one of your teams. Team 2 is these two notes. Your middle finger on this note right here, which is F sharp, and the other one on B. And you're just going. So I want you to do this with me. Practice really slowly. Just go between the two. Don't even try to play the song. And when I said don't bang the piano, just let the weight of your arms fall. Yeah, and just do this slowly. For the first week, don't even try to play the song if you're a first-time piano player. Just do this for me. Or a first day, whatever. All right? And now slowly speed it up. And then you'll see it'll get faster. And then watch, funny enough, the other hand's doing the exact same thing. Like a musician writer or songwriter, sometimes it's very effective. You're looking for notes in common. You have B minor, you have D major. If I play it like this, that's what the chord's on. But if you actually kind of sustain this B minor 7 chord, it just works over all the other notes. And it's kind of nice holding one voicing in one hand while the bass changes the color of the other hand. It's a nice trick. Anyways, for writing, it's kind of fun. Look how easy that is. Look, you're doing it at home already. Oh yeah, for that sneaky little note, if what you can do, you see which note they falls on. It's on the upbeat. Yeah, and then you get, it sounds like this when you speed it up. Same thing you learned before, so you already know that. Look, you're doing well, and that's how you play. And I just want to thank all the people who've been listening to my music, and take care of yourselves. Ta-ta. Bye-bye.